Hello, and welcome to Body Electric. Please join us today as we work our pectorals, deltoids, also outer thighs and inner thighs. And for today's show, you'll need your mat and some weights. And now, here's your host, Margaret Richard.
Hi, friends. Well, we have a guest in our house, Mary, back by popular demand. And of course, Jane, always by demand. And the biggest demand is for you to be with us. So I'm pleased that you are. We're going to, of course, warm up before the workout, and we want to kind of get the heart rate up and the muscles, give them the message that we're going to have some activity going on. So tuck under, bring the ear to the shoulder, and the ear all the way down, and again. And again. Look to the side. Shoulders are pressed down firmly. And side. Bend the knees slightly. Let's bring the arms up. And we're going to circle. And down, up, and down. Other arm. Just kind of loosen up. Round and around. Let it go, let it swing. And again. Okay, now let's round down, flatten the back. The head goes down last. Use your abdomen. And as you come up, just let your head hang. It's the last thing to come up. And once again, all the way down. And up. With the shoulders up and down, up and down. Really exaggerate. Okay, now let's lunge. I'd like you to think about your body being forward. I know some people tend to want to do that. You want to have a flat back and press into your hip. Other side and press. Change and change. Let's round up to the side. Now again, we want to have the knee over the ankle, tuck under, and the shoulders and hips facing the same direction. Pull it back. The hips are square and they're right under the shoulders. Try to flatten the back, get the stretch in back of the leg. Pull the toe up. Other side. Each time we do an exercise, each time you do, you have an opportunity to make it better, to be a little more particular about your form. Lifting the abdomen and back. Press back, press back. Think about a straight line from your head to your tailbone. And let's roll it up. And a deep breath. Ready to go? Ready? We're ready and hope you are too. Let's vary the exercise for the pectoral muscles. So we're going to begin on our backs using weights, and then we're going to turn over and do some push-ups. And just when our muscles think they've had enough, we're going to surprise them again. So let's on your back and cross one leg up so that the lower back is protected. The arms extend to the sides. And here we go. Take it to the middle, to the top, into the middle, and down. This exercise also works into the deltoid, the shoulder a little as well, so it's kind of a twofer. Contract the chest muscles to lift the arms. Contract. Lower back is pressed to the floor. Down and down. Up and up. As always, I encourage you to possibly start with heavier weights and then graduate to lighter ones as you need to. And before you know it, you won't have to graduate at all. Okay, let's put the weights down, roll to your side to sit up, and let's do a little push-up action. Going front, forward, down, down, up, and up. Your wrist is basically under your elbow. And down. Two more. Don't be intimidated by shaky arms, because it never stopped me, I can tell you that. How about one more? Last time. Stretch back. Okay, let's go. The adventure continues. At the bottom, halfway up and down. Halfway only. You should have your arms extended without the elbows being locked, just slightly rounded. Take it halfway. Be sure that your hands are not higher than your shoulders. In other words, your hands should be batted in line with your chest. Up and down. You know, I've mentioned this before, one of the reasons I like to work the pectoral muscles is that it makes the other arm exercises a little more intense when we're on a time budget. It helps matters. At the bottom, even smaller. Up and down. Small, use your shoulders, use your chest. Up and down. Last few. Three, two, and one. Okay, let's bring the weights in, and always roll to your side to sit up. That's the recommended way to do it. And why don't we take a stretch to the back. And now we're going to work our deltoids. Yay! Okay. At the top for two. Now, immediately, relax your fingers and press the shoulders down as if there were weights on your shoulders. The knees are slightly relaxed, hips are tucked. And the correct form would be to not lift your weights higher than your shoulders, but if your shoulders are pressed down, you simply can't. So that's your first clue you're not doing it right. And if you're really swinging those arms, that's your other clue that your weights aren't heavy enough. Get ready to change. Bend the elbows. In for two. Out for one, and in for two. Don't bring the arms behind your body, just to the side. And two. Your elbows are as high as they can go with the shoulders pressed in, which should be lower than the shoulders. Extend the arms in and in. Out and out. The arms stay in front of the body. So if they're going behind your side seam, let's hope that you have a side seam on. Then you're going too far to the back. You know, know, one of the things that I care about is that I know you always try to look your best for us, but I don't want you to, like, overdo. No need to have an extensive wardrobe. Palms up. If there isn't a chance that anybody could be doing this work, I'd stay in their 90s. Wouldn't it be great? You tuned in one day, and here we are in our, might be great for some of you, but it wouldn't be good for us. Don't take the arms too high, just above the shoulders and below. Palms facing in, and in. Now, if the weights get heavy for you and you have to sacrifice form, put the weights down and continue without them. Two more. One more. Palms facing down, down, up for two. Last few. Okay, just let's place the weights by our side, lift the shoulders, and down. Good. Working the outer thighs, we're using leg weights because we have them. And if you don't, it's absolutely fine to do without them. As a matter of fact, if you're doing the exercise correctly, you can create a great deal of intensity by having proper form. So let's begin by placing the entire body on the floor, reaching forward with the top arm to separate the shoulder blades, bending the knees with the feet directly under the hips. Here we go. Lift and lower. When you lower, I'd like you to stop just short of resting. The knee and the foot should be at about the same level. I ask you to reach forward so that enables you to keep the top hip forward so your hips are one on top of the other. Up and down. Abdomen is in. Okay, let's extend the leg, flex the foot, and up and down. It's a rather small range of motion. I want you to get into that contraction and just think about intensifying it. So there's not much of a release going on here. Make sure that your bottom leg is bent so you have a nice base of support. Up and down. Squeeze your gluteal muscles, that gives you stability as well. Hold it and flex the knee forward. Make sure you're bringing the knee forward rather than pushing the foot to the back. In and out. Always working no higher than your hip. Slowly. In and in, so the knees are on top of one another, and out. Press out, pull the top hip forward. In and in, out and out. Hold it, up and down, small. Small and contracted. You're using the outer thigh to move the leg. Put all your concentration there. And flex the knee in and out. In, out, in, out. You should be feeling the fatigue anytime now. A few more. Let's bring it in again, so the knees are one on top of the other. Push out, and in, and out. we're just about there. Hold it. Up and down, very small. For two and one, and bring the leg down with ever so much grace and poise. And let's sit up and stretch. Hey, you're still smiling. Sit into the working leg, so you're sitting squarely on both hips. Okay, other side. Now, Mary, did you forget which leg you just worked? I apparently didn't make enough of an impression. Okay, the knees are bent, the feet under the hips, and reaching forward. Ready, go. Up and down. Now, being that Mary is an active member of the Over 40 and Fabulous Club, Jane and I were thinking we should have like an out-of-towners meeting, like a chapter meeting for the out-of-town guests. And, you know, Mary, maybe we should make you our official out-of-town chapter president. But Jane, don't get jealous. You won't intrude on your field trips and your activities. Jane is very territorial about her field trips. Up and down. Extend the leg, very small, up and down. Keep reaching forward. So we should have chapters probably in every state of this great country, and then probably go up into Canada, and then we could start working our way into Europe, Asia, Africa, Australia, the poles, north and south, in and out. And listen, you know, what's wrong with other planets? You know what? I'm the president of this club. I think we ought to just keep it for Earth. I'm not sharing this with the moon. This is just the Over 40 and Fabulous Club for this Earth. Thank you very much. No other planets? Inquire. Thank you. Up and down. Up and down. Hey, you know, you guys have been real quiet, but you didn't remind me that we have to go in and out. Okay, just up and down. Did you notice how with our Over 40 and Fabulous Club meeting going on, how quickly the time flies? I know, I noticed that too. Up and down. Okay, last few, in and out, flex the leg. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and we're done. And sit up and take a stretch. Here's what I say, and you can quote me if you like. Strong legs are happy legs. Okay. With that said, we're going to work the inner thighs. Place your hands under your hips, the knees just above the hips, and if you are comfortable straightening the legs, that's fine. If not, you can keep them bent. Here we go. Notice we're keeping the leg weights on, those of us that have them. Flex the feet, and again, if you don't have them, I say no problem, you'll still get a great workout. Don't feel deprived. Pull the toes down hard. Keep going. Now, if you find that you're not able to keep your ankles above your hips, and your back is arching, please don't do that. It doesn't accomplish anything but hurt your back. Okay, think of this. The impetus or the motor for the movement is in the inner thighs. So that's where all the energy is coming from. In and in. Continue. Out and out. Pull the toes down. This is not about how far you can extend the legs to the outside. It has more to do with controlling the muscles. Out for two. Halfway up. Halfway up only. That means maybe no closer together than shoulder width. Lift your legs using the inner thighs. I like this inner thigh exercise because the body is protected, the legs are working, you get to look at your feet, and like we have kind of new shoes on, and I don't know, I'm enjoying my shoes, are you guys? As long as I don't have to enjoy somebody else's shoes over my face, I'm okay. Slowly up. One, two, three, and touch. And out, four counts. Slowly. Jane, did you make an appointment to get your nails done or something? You seem to be in such a hurry. Slow it down, man. The glory of being the only one with the microphone. Hold it out. And just a small pulse, out and in. Separate your shoulder blades, press your lower back down, abdomen is in, shoulders are down, and your legs are doing overtime. Last, two, one, all the way in, bend the knees, roll to your side, sit up, and stretch into the extended leg. How good is that?
An article in Shape magazine by Barbara Graham reports, a funny thing happened once Americans started obsessing about eating a low-fat diet. We forgot about moderation. The average American has gained 8 pounds over the past decade, and now a third of us are overweight. That's a 30% increase from 1980. Did you know that an average serving of pasta, which contains very little fat, can reach 600 calories or more before the sauce? And bagels can be as much as 400 to 500 calories each. We need to eat when hunger first strikes, before it gets out of control. And be good to yourself. Remember, less is more.
Thanks for joining us today. A special thanks to Mary, our guest, for once again joining us. And as always, to Jane. I think it's been about, 12, 13 years, Jane, that you've been joining us. And how can we ever thank you? So let's cool down. Let's extend one leg. Sit up tall, sitting equally, evenly on both hips. Okay, and let's reach up and out. Long. Down, and the same thing to the other side. With the chin dropped and the arm over the ear. Make sure both hips stay on the floor. And let's change legs. Swing the arm inside the leg and stretch long. Drop the chin. And to the other side. Now, those of you that are comfortable extending both legs, do so. It requires a little more flexibility. Now, let's just kind of walk the hands forward just a little. You still want to maintain the straight line from your head to your tailbone. So we don't want to lean over.